Is it me earlier?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello to our parents in the building and on Zoom and on Facebook. Let us begin our worship service with our prayer.
Thank you.
development. No matter who you are, or where you are from, or where you happen to be at this very moment, you are welcome as part of the community of First Baptist Church. And if you're a visitor with us today, we're so glad you chose to spend the morning with us. And if you'd like to let us know a little bit about yourself, those in the building, there are cards and pews right in front of you. And if you're joining us on Facebook, visitors or regular attenders, please leave us a comment so I can know that you're here. First, I want to say thank you to you all for making it possible for me to have vacation in July. And I had a great time, and I'm so glad to be back. So it's lovely to see you all here. And I look forward to catching up with everybody about how their July went. We have just a few announcements. We have a region committee meeting tomorrow in the church building at 10:30. It also can be accessed on Zoom. I'll send out the Zoom link tomorrow morning. So if you're on the region committee, I'll see you tomorrow at 10:30 a.m. And want to look ahead to August 25th will be our church picnic at Ethan Allen Homestead. And next week we'll have a sign-up sheet so you can understand you're coming. The church will provide burgers and hot dogs, and then we ask folks to bring salads and desserts and whatever else you want to eat. It's always a really fun afternoon, so please put it on your calendar and make plans to join us. The back-to-school backpack and school supply drive is going amazingly well, and I want to thank everyone who contributed to that. It's a wonderful ministry that First Baptist has to provide backpacks and school supplies to the children of our church. It's kind of a nice thing. First Baptist goes to school with them, and they know that the blessings and the prayers of this congregation are with them as they go through their school year. So thank you to everybody who has participated in that so far. Any other announcements that need to be made today? Let us begin worship together at singing our congregational intro, which is printed in the bulletin and
Turn your hymnals to
scripture texts are all about Jesus as the bread of life. And so our service today will have extra prayer and extra music, singing, as we all contemplate and ponder Jesus as the bread of life. So at this time, I invite the kids to join me on the front pew if they want to come up. In the back there. Okay.
Gospel of John, the 6th chapter, the 4th verse. Now Passover, the festival of the Jews, was near. When he looked up and saw a large crowd coming toward him, Jesus said to Philip, "Where are we to buy bread for these people to eat?" He said this to test him, for he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 6 months' wages would not buy enough bread for each of them to get a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are they among so many people?" Jesus said, "Make the people sit down." Now, there was a great deal of grass in the place, so they sat down, about 5,000 in all. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who received them. So also the fish, as much as they wanted. When they were satisfied, he told his disciples, "Gather up the fragments that are left over, so that nothing may be lost." So they gathered them up, and from the fragments of those 5 barley loaves left by those who had eaten, they filled 12 baskets. When the people saw the sign that had been done, they began to say, "This is indeed the prophet who is to come among the world." When Jesus realized that they were about to come and take him by force to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain by himself. When evening came, his disciples came to the sea, got into a boat, and started across the sea to Capernaum. It was now dark, and Jesus had not yet come to them. The sea became rough because a strong wind was blowing. When they had rowed about 3 or 4 miles, they saw Jesus walking on the sea, coming near the boat, and they were terrified. What he said to them, "It is I, do not be afraid." Then they wanted to take him into the boat, and immediately the boat reached the land towards which they were going.
Our next hymn is number 698, "Let Us Talents and Tongues Employ."
Thank you.
We have come together and we are speaking our truth to God. God hears us and God listens. So let us pray together the unison prayer confession, which is printed in the bulletin. God of unity and love, place within each of us a spirit of hope and community. Have mercy upon us when we speak without love or act without humility. Cleanse us with the living water of your grace and feed us with the bread of life. Create in us willing hearts to live with patience and gentleness. Raise us up to be your children, growing toward maturity in faith and love. Strengthen this church that we may be a model of ministry and unity for all the world to see. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Know, dear friends, that we are knit together by the very bonds of Christ's love for us. As the living water, Christ washes us clean and makes us a new creation. As our bread of life, Christ nurtures and sustains us. Forgiveness is ours, both now and forevermore. Amen. Let us now sing hymn number 426, Blessed Assurance.
Jesus answered them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent. So they said to him, what sign are you going to give us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What work are you performing? Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written. He gave them bread from heaven to eat. Then Jesus said to them, very truly I tell you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is what is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. They said to him, sir, give us this bread always. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty.
Our next hymn is number 705, You Satisfy the Hungry Heart.
Thank you.
We pray for those near and those around the world. We pray for individuals and for nations and for the whole world. At this time, I'm going to lift up a few names of folks who are on our prayer list, and then I will open it up. Folks can lift up the names or situations in the world that we would like to pray for. And after each name, together, let's say, Lord, hear our prayer. So first, we'll lift up, and I ask you to just use first names instead of the whole names, because we're live streaming. We want to protect people's privacy. So right now, first, we lift up Rebecca and her family. Lord, hear our prayer. We lift up Steve. Lord, hear our prayer. We lift up Christine. Lord, hear our prayer. We lift up the Shawmany family. Lord, hear our prayer. We lift up those impacted by wildfires out west. Lord, hear our prayer. We lift up those in the path of the tropical storm headed toward Florida. Lord, hear our prayer. We lift up the people of Ukraine. Lord, hear our prayer. The people of Burma. Lord, hear our prayer. The people of Gaza and Israel. Lord, hear our prayer. If you'd like to lift up, I just invite you to say the names out loud of folks you'd like to pray.
Carolyn.
Let's pray for Carolyn. Lord, hear our prayer.
Jenna.
Jim.
J-I-N-N.
Jenna. Let's pray for Jenna. Lord, hear our prayer. As we hold these prayers and many more, I invite us to enter more deeply into prayer. We know that God is always with us, closer than our very breath, just waiting for us to reach out and experience God's presence with us. So I invite you to sit comfortably in your seat with your feet planted on the floor and your hands resting gently in your laps or at your side. And I invite you to close your eyes and just begin to breathe deeply and gently. Breathe in God and breathe out peace. Breathe in God and breathe out peace. With each in-breath, envision the love of God filling you with warmth and light, entering in through your nose and relaxing your face and expanding your mind. Breathe in God and breathe out peace. Envision the love of God filling your lungs and moving to warm and lighten your heart. Breathe in God and breathe out peace. Envision the love of God expanding your torso and straightening your back. With each breath, the warmth and the light flows, reaching through your arms, to your elbows, your wrists, your hands, and your fingers. From your hips, to your knees, to your ankles, to your feet, to your toes. Every part of you is infused with the love of God. Breathe in God and breathe out peace. Now bring to mind those we have lifted up in prayer. Envision this light and warmth flowing to them, filling them with love and peace. Breathe in God. Envision the love of God flowing out into the world, comforting, healing, empowering. We in God can breathe out peace. Ever present and ever loving God, we rest in you. We are held and supported and encouraged by you. Pour your love and light and warmth into all those who suffer, from illness or hard circumstances, from poverty or oppression. There are so many without hope, so many without opportunity. Breathe your love into each one. Open the hearts and minds of those who act in fear. Relax our tendency to put up barriers and walls of protection. Tame the worldwide temptation of violence and desire for control. Empower us all to live out your love and welcome. We thank you, God. We thank you for our existence. We thank you for our Christ. Hear us as we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Our next hymn is number 346, and you can remain seated if you'd like. O come to me, the Master.
Thank you. comes to me will never be hungry. And whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Then the religious leaders began to complain about him because he said, I am the bread that came down from heaven. They were saying, is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How can he now say, I have come down from heaven? Jesus answered them, do not complain among yourselves. No one can come to me unless drawn by the Father who sent me, and I will raise that person up the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they shall be taught by God. Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Very truly, I tell you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh.
This morning, we are lifting up prayers and praise, pondering bread. We are being encouraged and empowered by the Spirit of God moving among us. In response to the blessings and the sustenance that we receive, we're invited to give back to God so that the work of God's kingdom may grow, that others may be fed as well. So to contribute to the ministries of First Baptist, you can give electronically, or you can give the old-fashioned way, by paper, or through your prayers and your presence and your activities, participation with us. However you are part of First Baptist, it is so deeply, deeply appreciated. Our many offerings will now be received. ministry. Transform our lives into your presence in the world. Through these gifts, may we grow in the knowledge of Christ and be strengthened in the unity of faith. Transform these gifts into the bread of life, so that in our giving, others may be fed. Make these gifts the waters that spring up into eternal life, so that in our giving, others may be nurtured and strengthened as children of God. In your loving and nurturing name, we pray. Amen. Our next hymn is number 404, Hope of the World.
Grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled.
It is in dying that we are born again to eternal life. In Christ's name, amen. Our hymn of preparation for communion is number 696, Come Share the Lord. And you can stay seated if you want, or stand up. I don't know if it's cooler standing or sitting, so. But let us sing number 696.
Broke it. And after giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples. you did.